What's going on everybody, this is Kurt and I'm back with a new video. I've just started my journey here, so for the newcomers, Primal VFX is the place where we learn about visual effects, CG and much more. Few months ago I've discovered a really cool motion graphic effect. So today we will discover how to make it with the help of the mighty Mash plugin inside Maya. So get relaxed, grab a coffee or a cup of tea and let's roll the intro! So here we are guys inside Maya. First off, for creating this captivating FX animation, we need of course an interesting 3D model. So I had the possibility to get this awesome sneaker 3D model. A truly nice looking asset. The look, the topology, the UVs are really well made. All the maps are packed in UDIMs. And the cherry on top, the scene provided is clean and tidy as I like it. I must express a very warm thanks to Whooper for sharing me this stunning asset. It's surely a talented 3D character artist from Paris. Check his ArtStation portfolio because you will be surprised by his projects. This sneaker model is part of a larger project for his CG character named Jane. He's already made a cool looking bomber for Jane character too. Also, during the recording of this video, he just told me that the Jane sneakers will be soon released on his Gumroad. So really, thank you mate. And for those who are interested, all the links will be in the description. Okay, let's now create our effect. We will do so with a mesh system. I'm duplicating the shoes and combine all the geometries to make one element to drive the mesh effects. Now we can create a small rig to animate it easily later on. I'm just creating a circle knurps and attach it to the shoes. Okay, sweet. Okay, now let's create our mesh system. But first, I create a simple cube that will be our driver for the effects. So then, go into the animation drop-down menu list. Click on mesh and create mesh network. Be sure to select instancer rather than mesh for geometry type. Apply it and open the mesh editor. Now for the distribution, we want to scatter the cube on our sneaker. So select mesh and in input mesh, drag and drop our dummy geo. We can use face area to scatter on every face of the object. Increase the number of points. Now let's add a signal node to make some random noise transformation. And last but not least, let's add a trails effect. It will create a trail for every movement of the cubes. Let's switch the noise input signal form 4D noise to curl noise and the transformation type to local. Nice, getting there, but not quite yet. Now we can create a shader to see the effects better. Let's increase the points and trails to 1000. We can also increase the time scale to 3. We can do the same thing to the noise scale. Nice. Let's make tweaks on the curve shape. Boom. Really, really nice. We can now duplicate the entire mesh system to make another system a bit different to add complexity. And we can switch the noise type to 4D noise. Let's make some other tweaks.
Hey you, I know you're watching my video and I know you're not subscribed yet. It's literally so easy, just go down there and boom, press subscribe. So like this video, comment and hit the subscribe button.
Now let's focus on the animation part. Let's create a camera and change the focal length to 50 mm. I change again the focal length to 35 mm. Now adjusting the framing of the shot to make it visually interesting. Something like that will be fine. Let's create some keyframes. Okay, nice. Now let's open my secret weapon for smooth ease in and out keyframes. It's a small MEL script named Easy Easy Ease. If you're interested in it, you will have the link in the description. Right now, I'm adjusting the timing of the animation, tweaking and tweaking the ease values. Okay, really nice smooth animation. Okay, let's begin the lighting of the scene and the look development of it. So we can import my studio default scene. Now we can adjust the backdrop a bit. Let's move the front light to create a rim light. I solo the light in the IPR to see better what I'm doing. Adjusting the exposure and the size of the light. Now I'm doing the same thing with the right light. Now I pick the left light and move it below the sneaker. Yes, something like that. It's quite interesting. Making some few adjustments now. Boom, a really interesting lighting done in no time. Okay then, let's adjust the exposure of the bottom light. Now I'm controlling the sequence if there are any overexposed lights. Okay, good. Now let's create an Arnold shader for our mesh effect. After putting some base color, roughness and emission value, let's add a ramp node. Now we can plug it to the base color and emission color. Let's make a 3-point ramp and input some hot colors. Adjusting a bit now the values. Okay, sweet. Now we have just to render it and make a bit of compositing. And voila, the final result. Really, really nice. What do you think, guys? This is a really cool way of doing some awesome trails effect.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.